Tanya Charles has walked this country since she was a little girl. But it's one memory in particular that has stayed with the Muddy Muddy Woman.
I remember coming out here one time with my old grandmother, my Nana Kelly. As it got darker, there was this crying, and it was a wailing crying. I took off over to Nana and I said, "Can you hear that, Nan?" I said, "What is it? Who is it, Nana?" And she said it was Lady Mungo crying to come home.
It would take another 40 years to have the remains returned, and they'll soon be reburied. The World Heritage Listed National Park is a place of particular significance to Barkindji, Muddy Muddy and Yampa people.
Take me back to Mungo. Thank you, Barkindji.
As the federal minister announced the remains would be returned to the earth, Tanya Charles watched the heavy clouds roll over and droplets fall. A sign from her ancestors and those who've passed since the journey began.
I was really, really emotional because I've seen the first elders come out here and start that fight for the return of our people. And I've seen a lot of elders after them too. And I know the rain from the sky today is the tears from all our people that passed on and never got the opportunity to see the final end of this fight.
Patricia Winch, a Muddy Muddy elder, says she's glad she's still around to see the reburial happen.
I've lost four sisters in the time that this has been going on. I'm happy that I'm still here, that it's not going to drag on for another 40 years, that this burial's going on, you know, it's going to happen very shortly.
The remains of Mungo Man were returned to country in 2017. Mungo Lady had already been repatriated in 1992. Since then, they've been kept at the National Park Visitors Centre. Patricia says reburying them will be healing for them and for future generations.
We've got the Dewey, the spirit. Now that's all freshness now. We can move on to the next level now and do the right thing.
Federal Environment Minister Susan Ley says the decision to rebury the remains was an easy one to make.
Because it is so supported by the Aboriginal Advisory Group, which represents three tribal groups, and many of whom I've spoken to over many years and who have acknowledged the challenges and the difficulties in the decision. But in the end, the right decision was the easiest decision to return the remains of Mungo Man, Mungo Lady, in fact 108 skeletal remains, back into the ground, into the landscape, close to where they came from. That's what respects Indigenous traditional culture, and that's what we as a nation must do.
But not everyone agrees that reburial is the best outcome. Michael Young is a Barkindji man who had wanted a keeping place built for the remains.
The federal minister has just killed what is left of world heritage in Australia. By doing this, she will allow the destruction of heritage. And our heritage, obviously, is at the top of the list.
Barkindji people are recognised as native title holders over the majority of the national park. But Michael feels his people have been left out of the conversation, saying the minister has consulted only with the advisory group.
The reality is she's only consulted with the AAG, which is an advisory group set up by National Parks, NOEH, New South Wales, to essentially fill their own agendas. We feel that they are an advisory group. They have no power. They have no say in management of the park. And on top of that, they're selected randomly. So the other two groups are not traditional owners, recognised through native title. The only group that is happened in 2015, and that's the Barkindji Perenti people.
But the minister says otherwise.
No one was ignored. Everyone was listened to. Everyone was heard. And overwhelmingly, the consultation that I conducted through the process which saw this decision made at the national level, overwhelmingly, the response to that public consultation supported today's outcome.
Tanya Charles is glad her grandmother's campaign is now coming to an end.
And I'm just so glad that everything that they wanted is right in front of us for future generations. So that's what it's all about, is the young ones, and not having them carry the burden that our first elders carried.